you guys, welcome back to Shauna here, and it's so good to see you. So today's video, we're going to be working on something similar to the last video, which was enamel mug mockups in Photoshop. We're going to be doing the same thing. In this video of making things, we're going to be working on sticker mockups. So for the same reasons why we did the enamel mug mockups or any mug mockups, was for one, consistency, and two, efficiency, workflow. We're going to be doing the same thing for stickers. So again, if you have a design like this one, and then you take a photo of it, and then you have another photo, another design, and then you take a photo of it, and then you have another, and another. So it doesn't really make much sense to design it, make it, take a photo, and then a couple days later, design it, make it, take a photo. In doing that process, you're going to create some inconsistencies. So to create consistency and to keep up with consistency, we want to make a mockup. So we're going to skip again the photo shoot and the editing of the photo itself, and we're going to jump into creating the mockup in today's video. I can get into how I make stickers, how I design them, how I print them out, how I cut them, how I make them in another video, but for this one, it's going to be editing mockups. So without further ado, let's get into making things, sticker mockups.
Okay, so here we are in Photoshop, and I just brought in the background and I am going to duplicate it. The reason for this is I don't want to adjust anything on the original. I want to make changes and brighten it up a little bit. So over in the corner, I'm hitting image and then clicking levels, which is Command M, and I'm going to bring up this side, which is like the lights, keep the middle in the middle for the mid-range, and then adjust the bottoms for the dark tones. And just slightly adjust and click the preview so you can see what it was before and after. So it's very slight, but it's what I need for now. So click OK. So now I want to bring in my image. So you can do it several ways. You can do file, place embedded, which is what's happening in the top left, but I just want to click and drag. So here are my images, my PNGs, and I'm just going to simply click and drag it into my artboard right here. And you can see the white background. It's pretty apparent. If you have a PNG, you can always export it as transparent, but this is white and that's fine, and I can show you how to fix this so it blends in much better with your mockup. So I'm just going to click this side and bring it in a little bit so I can fit it over the image in the back. And it doesn't have to be perfectly on top of it, but I do want to make it a tiny bit smaller so that the words that I have, like the name Coco and Seed, and that's not at the edge of the sticker. So I'm just going to make it a tiny bit smaller and then click Enter. And then what Enter will do is just stamp it right there. There you go. So to get rid of the white background, I'm going to click on this blending options and click multiply. So now you can see that the white that was originally there is completely gone, and now it's just the black. So that is as if I printed it out in my printer, and that's what it's going to look like. So let me zoom in a little bit. And so yeah, I'm happy with that. Now we're going to bring on the artwork. I have a variety of PNGs. I'm just going to click and drag it just like we did for the backing right there. And again, just grabbing the corners and sizing it down to fit what I need. So whenever you're doing this in the future, I like to use a white cardstock or whatever it is that you want to put the mockup on to be the what's similar to what you're using. So if you have a 4x6, a 5x7, an 8.5x11, you want to cut out or use a blank page of whatever it is that you're going to copy so it looks more realistic. You don't want to use an 8.5 by 11 sheet of paper if your sticker cards are much smaller. So here's my image. So you can see that there's a white outline around my stickers, which is how the machine cuts it out and what I want, but I don't necessarily want it to show and be that obvious in Photoshop. So what we could do is go in to the blending modes like we did before and get rid of it. However, if we do, we're going to lose the visual of what the sticker looks like. So these are actually kiss cut stickers. So what that means is the sticker and the backing are one, but you can peel off the sticker and the backing will remain. To keep that effect, what we're going to do is duplicate the background. I'm just going to call it sticker backing, changing the blending mode to normal so that we retain that white outline. So I'm going to click on stroke, and that will put a white stroke around the sticker. You can click that plus sign to bring up your different color options, and you can just click and drag it around and get a different color. But white is the background of the paper, so I'll just keep that. And it's F 6 times or F 3 times, hit enter, and you'll get that. The next thing I want to do is fill in the middle. So obviously that's not how the stickers are, so let's fill that in with white. So to do that, I'm going to go down to the effects, blending options, and a window will pop up, and we'll click on color overlay and do the same thing. Hit the plus if that color isn't available to you. Hit OK. Now what we'll do is move the sticker backing behind the original sticker, and now you can see the original layer had a multiply blending mode on it, and the sticker backing is just normal, but it is too bright, so we'll bring it down so it looks a little more realistic. So around 40 should be good. So now it's clearly defined what's a sticker and what's not on the backing due to that light outline. And that right there is it. That's how you can create a simple mockup that you can use over and over again for the different designs that you make.
All right, you guys, I hope you liked that video. It was informative or entertaining in some way. And you know what to do, hit that like button, also subscribe, and if you feel so inclined, leave a comment down below. And I will see you in the next video. Bye.